I have been summoned to court in the future, in the very soon to be present future. I have been summoned to appear in court for speeding. I was speeding. You really shouldn't speed, but like everyone does it, so when you do get pulled over for speeding, it's like everyone does this. Why are you pulling me over? Why are you pulling me over? I mean, I was going 10 over, which is like, I was going like 13 over, actually. I was going 53 and a 40. Which is, not good. It's not something you should do. So yeah, I got a court summons. And I did this whole pullover thing all the wrong way. what seems to be the problem, officer? He's like, can I see your license and registration? I did not have my car's registration on me. That is not something that should happen. You should have your registration on you. But, he saw that I had my receipt, the receipt from the car purchase. He took that instead. I guess it was able to have it has the right information necessary. It's registered on me and my dad, Douglas. So, yeah, and then he took my license back to his car. I'm just sitting there, like, text my friend. See, I usually am a very attentive driver, but that particular night, I was deep in thought about a thought. I'm joking. She's a very respectable young lady, very well put together, moderately well adjusted to being an adult individual. I say that because she's better than me, but she's still not... as I would consider to be a fully healthy-minded individual. There are definitely things wrong with her, as there are things wrong with everyone, really. So, this was the night before my friend left for California. And I was unable to make her goodbye dinner that she had planned the day after. I had to get all of my date conflicts in for rehearsal for Heathers, the production of Heathers that I'm in right now. So she planned it the day after I had to get all my conflicts in. So I wasn't able to go. She was very mad at me, and I tried talking to my director about it, about what was going on, and how she was mad at me for missing the thing. I ended up not being able to go because her first professional production, and I needed to be at rehearsal. As soon as rehearsal, I got out of rehearsal like an hour early because they weren't working with people in the background, people, the extras or the policemen, which I'm one of the two policemen on the show. And so me and my friend Bobby weren't needed. Soon Bobby had an hour to kill, so we started to just hang out in the city for a little bit. So we went to Canalside, Buffalo, the day of the Rockheads, I believe. No, was it Leatherhead, Rockhead, something head band. They were playing, and me and Bobby got into the concert. $5 a ticket wasn't that bad of a deal, so we went in. Played Pokemon Go a little bit. Lots of fun. Lots of cannabis being smoked. My Bobby is, my friend Bobby is a friend, is a 420 friendly gentleman. And he kept on saying, weed, weed everywhere, but not a puff for me, because he was underage, and no one was going to take a chance of giving an underage kid a puff of their kush. And I foolishly took a video of the Leatherhead concert, posted it on my Snapchat story, and my friend, my very important friend, who's moving to California, saw it, got mad because she thought that I had chosen to go to a concert instead of going out to eat with her for farewell dinner. As they do, they assume people, assume things. So I don't like to assume. She, commented, like, what the fuck is this? What? And I was like, I went after rehearsal, and she's like, okay. Yeah, if you want someone to be totally, like, not worried about what you think about the situation, don't respond with K. Don't respond with K to anything. Don't respond. No, that's just so, just hard. It's so, no. Just don't respond with K. Oh my god. So sassy. It's so bad. I just, ugh. Don't respond with K, okay? Okay? So I felt really bad. So I took Bobby home to his place. And I drove back home and I'm just really feeling bad about not being able to make it to my friend's farewell dinner. So I thank Fudge Fiddly Fingletard Sticks. I'm going to go to her house and bid her a proper farewell before we never see each other ever again. Probably not, but this is the way it feels. Okay? So I text my mom, gonna go say goodbye to Rose before she leaves tomorrow morning, because I just didn't want to wake up at 6. At 6. Go to be at the airport by freaking 7:20 when she gets for her flight leaves. Well, no, her flight leaves at 8:20 and I don't want to be there at 7 to just watch her go. And I'm not even going to be fully there because I'm going to be like asleep. If I want to be there, I want to be fully there and emotional and crying as she walks away, which I can't be if I'm half asleep so early in the morning. So that's why I just wanted to say goodbye to her at her house. So I get there, she isn't home yet from the farewell dinner because it's all the way in Pennsylvania. It's down south in Pennsylvania. So I wait there for like 20 minutes, 30 minutes. She gets home and I surprise her out of the car. She hugs me, yada, yada, yada. Asks if I'm going to stay over. I'm like, no, I can't because I got to be in the city tomorrow morning. And then her other friend, Noah, who was sitting in the front, she was like, oh, well, I'm staying over and I also got to be in the city tomorrow and I'm going to be at the airport with her. And then she looked. And then my friend looks at me like I'm the worst. Well, maybe I am the worst. But I don't want to be there if I'm not going to be there in my head. Like, awake and emotional and crying as you walk away. I'm going to literally just be standing there like the half undead zombie that I am when I in the morning when I'm not fully awake. Like, sure, I can, like, function like a human being. If school's taught me anything, it's taught me how to function while half asleep. So I help Noah, my friend's friend, with the same name as me, Noah. I help him and my friend get all of her bags and whatever into her house so I can, like, say goodbye and everything. But literally all she did for the entire time while I was just trying to say goodbye to her was just be really sassy and really rude about how I didn't want to be there when she got on the flight. Like, I didn't want to meet her at the airport. Like, she was just so rude about it. Like, so what? You want me there when I'm literally dead? You want me just there? I mean, maybe I'm the worst. Maybe I am. I probably am definitely the worst. I've been the worst. Maybe I'm the worst, but I just really didn't want to be there. So she like freaking guilt tripped me and everything. And I've guilt tripped people. And I realized how mean guilt tripping is. I've guilt tripped people. It was just, I just feel really bad about doing so. But she just has no remorse. She had no remorse about just straight up guilt tripping me into being there. Like, I didn't want to be there. Because again, I'm going to be a half dead zombie. Unemotional. As she walks away. And if I'm going to be there, I want to be like human. And I'm not going to be human if I'm asleep. Because I'll be a zombie. Y'all feel me? Y'all feel me? Come on. Thank you.